Hey guys, this is Karan Birani from MobiScrub and we're here to review the Panasonic Eluga S. Now, it's a mid-range smartphone, somewhere in the range between 10 to 11,000 in the market right now. But let's not call it mid-range because the specifications that support this device are actually quite nice. And of course, we see this trend across more and more devices now. So it's got Android 4.4.2 Kitkat right out of the box, a 1.4 GHz Octa Core processor, a 1 GB RAM support, and it's got a 5-inch HD display. It's 1280 by 720p display. The device is powered by a 2100 milliampere hour battery sealed inside this unibody shell, so that's not removable. Now this brings me to the design of the Eluga S, which is actually quite nice. It resembles the Note 3 in terms of the stitching pattern all throughout the border of the rear panel. The Leatherette finish is also extremely classy. I think I really liked what came with the Note 3 and the Note 4, and now it's in Panasonic Eluga S2, and I definitely think it's a step in the right direction when it comes to design language. In terms of the camera, you've got an 8-megapixel camera with LED flash and autofocus. You've got zero shutter lag, and it's capable of full HD video recording. What's really brilliant is the front-facing 5-megapixel camera, and we'll talk more about it a little later. The Eluga S is a mid-sized phone. It sits very comfortably in the palm of your hands, and as you can see, I can almost wrap my fingers around it. One-handed use is actually not that difficult. In fact, it's built for use with just your thumb. And most of that is possible because it's only 7.9 millimeters thick, which is actually very thin, comparable to the iPhone 5S actually. On the right-hand side, you've got a SIM card slot. The top, you've got a 3.5mm headphone jack, a 32GB microSD card slot, and at the bottom, you've got a USB 2.0 data syncing and charging port. Now, what's also really nice about the design is that the display part has this very elegant metallic finish, while the bottom part has a very soft and matte finish to it, which really lends a different class to the entire design. So there you go, guys. It's Android 4.4.2 KitKat running on the Panasonic Eluga S. Now, as you'll see with most smartphones, whether it's from HTC or from Samsung, they don't exactly stick to the Google stock experience. They have their own features and user interface. Now, the one that comes from Panasonic is called Fit Home UI, which is basically a thumb flick interface. So it's a user interface designed for single hand operation for enabling easy access, customization, and display of apps. So what you can really see is that I can only use my thumb to pretty much navigate the entire phone's display. And that's really easy because at the end of the day, that's what you really want, unlike very large displays where you need to use two hands. Now, of course, for the sake of this video, I'm going to use two hands because it makes my job easier. But you can definitely use this entire phone by just your one hand. Now, let me just quickly go into about device. And there you go, guys. That's Android 4.4.2 KitKat and hopefully upgradable soon. Now, of course, the UI comes with a couple of nifty features. One of them is actually double tap to sleep, or basically to lock your device. And of course, there are more of these and I'll talk about them. Now, you have up to 9 home screens. So you can add, you know, more widgets, you can add more shortcuts and place them onto your home screen. So whether it's your calendar widget or whether it's your weather widget, Google Keep, whatever. So you can have up to 9 home screens. That's really nice. The display of the Eluga S is 5 inches with a resolution of 720 by 1280 pixels. It's IPS HD display, so it's really nice. It's basically, you've got very good viewing angles. Even in bright sunlight, it's not really that bad. Now, I'll just show you a couple of wallpapers to basically take you through the color reproduction of the Eluga S. And as you can see, they're really nice, punchy colors. They're not overly saturated or they don't have high contrast, unlike the Super AMOLED displays that come on Samsung, which also has its own pros and cons, but these are really nice, pleasant, closer to natural colors, and hence nothing strikingly weird about them. Again, coming back to viewing angles, even when tilted to extreme angles, the colors don't wash away. The readability is actually quite nice, and it's just indicative of really nice display quality. The 5-inch display is a pretty good size. It's very pocket friendly, it's palm friendly, so you can using your single hand. You can watch HD videos, full HD, semi-HD, which is 720p, and of course, standard definition. Another nifty feature of the Eluga S that you can pop up the video, and you can be watching anything you want while you're still browsing the phone apps or widgets or using an app like WhatsApp or messaging or even Chrome for that matter. Talking about features, the Eluga S also comes with gesture play, which basically means that you can use gestures to unlock your phone to certain apps. If you go to security settings and lock screen, you can change that to gesture play, and you can create your own gestures to launch your own specific apps. The ones that come pre-built are unlock SMS and camera, and you can draw the similar shape to kind of unlock it directly to camera, or draw a V to unlock. And of course, you can create your own. The built-in music player of the Eluga S is something I found interesting in particular, especially in regards to its user interface. So of course, you've got your regular play, pause, next track, previous track, and shuffle options. But what's really nice is the seek part, the progress part, which you can play around with to jump ahead or go back in a song. And you know, the thumbnail at the back is basically the album cover, which makes it really nice and colorful. And as you can see, you can organize your songs by recently played, newly added albums, artists, songs, genres, and all of this is really colorful and nice. Of course, you've got a built-in equalizer, you know, set a song as ringtone, get more information on a song and add it to a particular playlist. And of course, search your songs from your entire song bank. And at last, let's talk about the camera of the Eluga S. You've got an 8-megapixel camera with LED flash and autofocus. This is the camera app. It's got a very simple UI. Of course, you've got a couple of options that are laid on the left, so you can, you know, toggle between live photo mode, beauty face. You've got panoramic shot right there, and then you can of course jump back to normal. You've got your shutter key and your video recording key. There's almost no lag when it comes to tapping and clicking a photo. So as you can see, I tap on the shutter key and it instantly takes a photo. You've got full HD video recording, and of course you can lower it down. You can take photos while you're recording videos, and of course pause your video and then resume it once you're done. Just tap on the video key again and your video is saved to the gallery. And you can play around with a couple of settings such as the shutter sound, the GPS location, add color effects, change the white balance and ISO modes. Zero shutter lag. Always keep that on. You always want that, right? You don't want any lag. You've got voice capture, and then you've got smile shot. You've got HDR capability, and you can take up to 40 shots in continuous mode. And of course, you can lower your pixel count if you wanted to. And now comes the most talked about and the best feature of the Eluga S, thanks to its 5-megapixel front-facing camera. It's called Blink Play. All you've got to do is blink, and it takes your selfie. That's it. Or you can just tap on the screen and it takes your photo. Now, this is probably the easiest way to take selfies using your front camera. So guys, in a nutshell, you've got a 5-inch HD display, a smartphone powered by an Octa Core processor with 1 GB of RAM, you know, a size which is so convenient to be used using single hand with just your thumb. You've got a couple of gesture features. So, you know, you can unlock your phone with gestures, or lock your phone with just double tapping on the home screen. You've got a beautiful design. You've got this really nice Leatherette finish with stitching pattern all across the border of the rear panel, a fabulous front-facing camera, and amazing multitasking speed. As you can see, I can switch between apps really quickly without any lag or delay. The animation, the screen transitions, the response to touch is actually quite nice. And even the entire user interface is quite versatile. And as you can see, and I can also use in landscape mode with ease, you know, making use of the entire 5-inch real estate that you get on the phone. So that's it about the Panasonic Eluga S. Thanks for watching, guys. Do leave me comments on what you think about the phone. Don't forget to like the video, and of course, do not forget to subscribe. Thank you, guys.